Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to Juggling Entertainment. Here, I'll give you hot gist of trending issues in Nigeria, in Africa, and the world at large. Please, for those that are new and miss, do a click the subscribe button to the bell and also the like so as to stay up with the times. What is trending right now in our beloved country, Nigeria, is the Big Brother Nigeria Season 6. Shine your eyes. The housemates are there catching their crews in the Big Brother house, and we, the viewers, are also outside watching the housemates catching their own crews in the Big Brother house. That's Big Brother for you. And so many things have been happening in the house. You know, you can't just put people in a house without seeing drama, and Big Brother is all about drama. It's all about entertainment, and it's basically a sport, and everybody's bringing his or her own strategy to win the 90 million naira. Especially with that economy we have in our beloved country Nigeria right now, money is very, very valuable. 90 million naira is big money, and everybody's bringing his or her own strategy to win the 90 million naira. What such person is white money. People have been criticizing white money that he is a calm, he's a cool, and he's a collected guy, yeah, because white money has always been in the kitchen. He's cooking, he's been cleaning, he's been making things sure everything is okay, and that is his own strategy, and he's been winning the hearts of the housemate and also the house of the fans. Recently, we knew what happened in the Big Brother house last week when Pere was made the head of house. Pere now said that there should be no longer be a kitchen monopoly, that white money should stop cooking. He actually banned white money from entering the kitchen or from preparing food, and it wasn't rosy at all, because most of the housemates were complaining that there was no food, there was nothing to eat. Everybody has his or her own strategy, and Pere has discovered white money strategy, that white money has been using the kitchen to please people's heart. And basically, I say this with white money, is white money has been having lots of followers out here. I say this with his strategy, because white money is winning people's hearts. You know, there's this adage that the shortest way or the shortest path to a man's heart is through his stomach. White money has been winning the hearts of fans and also housemates by using the stomach of housemates. That is white money. And Pere has been the house with his own dictatorial strategy, giving rules and regulation. He doesn't want anybody to break his rules. And we saw what happened last night when he had this exchange with white money. You know, he was asking white money some questions, and he even went as far as removing his belt, harassing white money, bullying white money by removing his belt. That is uncalled for. That is totally bad. He acted as if he was treating his younger brother. White money is a big boy. White money's strategy is preparing food to make sure he puts smiles on the faces of the housemates and even viewers out here. That is his strategy. Leave him, let him do his thing. You concentrate on your own is to be a dictator. But using the dictatorial strategy doesn't mean you should break another person's strategy. And we know another strategy he is using is by making us feel he has fallen in love with the most beautiful girl in the house. Because people have been saying Maria is the most beautiful girl in the Big Brother house. Yeah, Maria is very beautiful. She's a half caste, and Pere has been around her since they went into the Big Brother house. Pere has always been around her. Pere was given the head of house trophy, or Pere was made the head of house last week. He won the head of house challenge last week, and he nominated Maria as his deputy. This week, Maria is the new head of house, and guess what? Deputy. Well, that is the game. Big Brother Naija is a game. Everybody is looking for a way to go home with the 90 million naira. But by the way, who do you think will go home with this 90 million naira? People, so many persons out there are rooting for white money, because he's been winning this white money for you. And also, some persons have been supporting Pere because he's acting like a dictator in the house. Well, there's this tweet I saw on according to Solomon Bucci, he said, Pere acts like a narcissist. His stares and facial mannerisms reeks of condescension, need of power, and unfairness. He is that guy who feels like something when he's just nothing. And he's that boyfriend who will emotionally abuse you till you lose your mind. Avoid a Pere today. We hope if they come out of the house and maybe their relationship grows stronger, the relationship is trying to tie up with Maria, if the relationship builds, we hope he won't end up emotionally abusing Maria, according to what Solomon Bucci just said. What are thoughts regarding the housemates? Which person is playing the best game, or which of the strategies do you prefer the most? We have so many persons in the house. Angel is also there. Her own strategy is going like half naked. Is it half naked? No, half naked is when you are 50% covered. But she doesn't like being 50% covered. Maybe she likes 20 or 10%. Yeah, that is Angel for you. That is Angel's style. Everybody has his or her own style. Some places are just being calm, cool, and collected. They don't talk much. Some people talk much. Some people play around. That is the Big Brother drama for you. And some persons are in love in the house. Who do you think will go home with this 90 million naira? Please don't forget to drop a comment on the comment
about the Big Brother house. KV has withdrawn from the Big Brother Naija show due to his mental health and the breakdown he's had for this.
Wish him well. All the best, KV. Regarding what happened to KV, that this appears to be the big puzzle confronting Big Brother Naija, shine your eye, housemates, who have expressed concerns about KV's recent weird behavior in the Big Brother house. According to them, KV has been behaving strangely and withdrawn, and some of the housemates are very disturbed concerning the new development. While discussing with some housemates, White Money stated that KV is getting weird by the day and he wonders if it's a prank. Speaking about KV's strange attitude, went to white washing machine that was in use by someone else and turned it off. He went to the tap, opened it, and washed his face. He looked at us, hissed, and left. Is this a prank? This is not funny. Wild Money also stated that when he tried talking to KV, the guy refused and declined to return his pleasantries. Wild Money continued, it's not funny anymore. For real, it's no more funny. It's really getting weird. I don't know if he's playing a prank or has lost his senses. Commenting on the issue, JMK also agreed that KV is acting strange and the housemates have been telling Big Brother to do something about it. JMK said, we have been asking Biggie to please take him for a psych examination. It is bad. Wow. Well, according to reports, after this drama that happened around KV, we were told that medical personnel advised Big Brother to take him out of the house. And there was an announcement that read, and the announcement was read by the Big Brother head of house, who was Perry. The announcement read, housemates, Big Brother trusts that you are all well and settling into the brand new week. As you have noticed, your fellow housemate KV has been unwell for a few hours now. During this period, he has consulted with a medical doctor and has been advised to withdraw from the show to take care of his health. Based on this advice, KV will no longer be part of the show for this reason. KV would like you all to know that he appreciates the time spent in the house with everyone.
Truly means a lot to him.
Big Brother would like you to assist KV with packing his bags and belongings and place them in the store room immediately. This announcement left the housemates in tears as some of them were shedding tears as they helped KV to pack his bags. Wow. I think health is most important. Health, they say, is wealth. Yeah, you can't look for wealth when you are not healthy. But KV, we wish you all the best. Wish you all the best. I think, and that was a superb decision by Big Brother for following the doctor's instruction for removing KV from the house so that he will get medical attention. He really needs medical attention because he'd be acting very well. The way he talks, the way he reacts, and even the viewers have also noticed that KV was
well enough said about the Big Brother Naija show. Let's move on to politics. Not really politics, to what is happening in Afghanistan.
We are all human beings, and whether I like it or not, they are all our brothers and sisters. They are going through a lot. The drama in Afghanistan is not something you like to watch. Yeah, you can watch the Big Brother Naija show and smile, but what is happening in Afghanistan right now is terrible. As in, it's terrible to the solid degree. The day after Afghanistan President Ashraf Ghani fled and the Taliban installed themselves in the presidential palace in Kabul, uncertainty reigned. With thousands desperate to flee, Kabul's airport was a scene of chaos. As you can see from this picture, I can't even play those videos here because they were terrible. We see people flying, I mean, they were falling from planes. It was terrible. You can imagine, look at this picture, you can imagine the number of persons in the plane. That was actually done by the US government. They carried them to Qatar. And from reports, about 5 or 7 people have died because they fell off the plane. They were, I mean, they just wanted to leave the city at all costs because the Taliban are back in power. That is terrible. The Taliban have taken over Afghanistan. That is terrible news, terrible news. Very terrible. I mean, if you watch CNN or BBC or Al Jazeera and you see what is happening in Afghanistan, I mean, you regarded that female Afghan mayor reveals she expects Taliban to kill her. You can imagine people are just expecting the Taliban to kill them. That's why you see people at the airport, because that is like their only hope. They don't even know where to run to. The airport is their only hope, so that if they see any plane, they'll cling to that plane and leave the country. And they are leaving the country without anything, as in without any belongings. That is terrible. According to reports, the people of
Afghanistan are currently fearing for their safety now that the Taliban has regained control. And the first female mayor of an Afghan town has revealed that she is in fear of the Taliban coming to kill her as they impose their regime over the country. You know, there's one thing with these guys, with these Taliban. Yeah, they are basically men because they don't like anything. I mean, the way they treat women, they treat women like, is it inferiors? Say somebody is inferior, it's like, okay, the person is a person, but maybe the person doesn't have your status. They treat women like scraps. Let me just read their rules and regulations for you. According to the Taliban, according to their rules and regulations regarding women, they says, as a woman, you stay inside your home at all times. It is not proper for women to wander aimlessly about the streets. If you go outside, you must be accompanied by a maram. If you are caught male on the street, you will be beaten and sent home. You will not, under any circumstances, show your face. You will cover with bukwa when outside. If you do not, you will be severe. Cosmetics are forbidden. Jewelry is forbidden. You will not wear charming clothes. You will not speak unless spoken to. You will not make eye contact with men. You will not laugh in public. If you do, you will be beaten. You will not paint your nails. If you do, you will lose a finger. Girls are forbidden from attending school. All schools for girls will be closed immediately. Women are forbidden from working. If you are found guilty of adultery, you will be stoned to death. Listen, listen well, obey. Allahu Akbar. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. No, wahala. Wahala. This Taliban, I mean, they are only something else. They are only something else. Regarding the CNN reporter Clarissa Walsh was forced to wear hijab after the fall of Kabul to the Taliban. From the picture, you can see Clarissa Walsh before and after the fall of Kabul to the Taliban. These guys, we don't even know. Some persons are in support of what they are doing. That is life for you. Some persons are strictly against what they are doing. Please don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section below. What do you think about what these guys are doing? People are saying that they are religious fanatics. What do you think about them? Don't forget to drop a comment on the comment section. Regarding what these guys are doing in Afghanistan, the Taliban, you know, it's similar to what we experienced or we've been experiencing in Nigeria, what the Boko Haram are doing. And from the desk of Renault Omikri, he said, Nigeria bought 12 Super Tucano jets from the US for $593 million. The Taliban got them for free by defeating the US and the Afghan government. With the way Buhari romances Boko Haram, I just pray Nigeria's 12 Super Tucano jets will not become their property one day. Because what is happening in Nigeria today first happened in Afghanistan. The rehabilitation of so-called repentant Taliban by the US and Afghan government allowed them to act first as spies, then as enemies within, which was a chief causative factor in the rapid victory of the Taliban. May Nigeria learn her lessons before it is too late. We really need to learn lessons. I see reasons with what Renault Omikri does say. We really need to learn lessons because what is happening right now, we see Boko Haram coming in their numbers, asking the government for forgiveness, that they are now repentant. This is the same thing that the Taliban did in, you know, Afghanistan. They came and pleaded to the government of Afghanistan and the US government for repentance, that they have repented of their sins. They pleaded for help and they gave them, they didn't know they were working as spies. And now look at them, they've taken over Kabul. That is terrible. We just hope and pray that our country, Nigeria, will not be like Afghanistan, because it will be terrible. You can imagine the rules and regulations they are giving to women. How many women or how many ladies out there can put up with this? We really need to pray in this country. And regarding this drama that the Taliban are bringing up in Afghanistan, Joe Biden, who is the president of the United States of America, said, I stand squarely behind my decision. After 20 years, I've learned the hard way that there was never a good time to withdraw U.S. forces. U.S. President Joe Biden speaks after Taliban overthrew the government after the U.S. and other countries decided to withdraw their troops from Afghanistan. The question is, what is the way forward? I mean, because if those guys take over the whole country successfully, they will spread their tentacles. They'll start entering other nations. That one day, Mujahideen will have victory. And Islamic law will come not to just Afghanistan, but all over the world. We are not in a hurry. We believe it will come one day. Jihad will not end until the last day. That came from the desk of the Taliban commander. What is the way forward? What is the way forward? What do you think is the way forward for us to solve this menace in the world? Because if it's affecting people in Afghanistan, it will definitely spread to other parts of the world. Because what's happening in Nigeria, what is happening in Nigeria, the Boko Haram saga that's been happening in the country has been affecting everybody in the world because people are living in fear. Thank you very much for watching your blessed entertainment. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button to the bell and also the like so as to stay updated with the time. Take care of yourself and please do have a lovely day.